if you think about it, everything that we need to live a good life is here. This planet is beautiful. And we sometimes we get mistaken thinking that we can make it better. And, you know, Gary Snyder says, you know, it's crazy to think about making a better solar collector because God already made one. It's called a plant. The plant is already a perfect solar collector, and it fixes sugars, and it creates oxygen. And it's like, come on, can you do that? Can you improve on that? They want to go out into space. They want to figure out what to take with them to create oxygen while they're out there. They put their best guys on it. 10 years later, you know what they came up with? Take plants. They fire the guy. He's got all this data, what to do with it, so he writes a book about how to put plants in your house to purify the air in your house. It's like, come on, it's already there. It's beautiful, it's laid out, it's wonderful. And what the old people learned was, what is the proper attitude of a human being in the face of such beauty, in the face of such majesty? And they learned that the human being exists somewhere between the mountain and the ant. And we have to find what's the right attitude between here and here. And they discovered that it was gratitude. You can just say thank you because it's all so wonderful. And when you say thank you, now the heart math guys are telling us that our hearts open up when we are expressing gratitude. And they put electrodes on people and they test them, and they find that the waves that come off their heart are in a perfect relationship, which we would call 1.618, which is the Fibonacci number, which is the golden mean, which is the way that nature is constructed. When we say thank you, we become perfectly beautiful. When somebody smiles in happiness, their face assumes the ratio of 1.618. And we notice that that person is so beautiful because they're smiling all the time, they're happy, they're expressing their gratitude and happiness. So there's this marvelously simple thing we can all do, and that is to remember to say thank you a lot, yeah. And so that's kind of one of the secrets of the tracking project, is this Thanksgiving address that we got from the Iroquois. And I would share that with Parley and my friend from Hanna, and he felt it was so important just to be able to say thank you. Because when we forget to say thank you, our mind becomes chaotic. And when we're in chaos, we're not in prayer anymore. We're not centered. We have to find our way back to the center. You step out of the center and it's all crazy. And then you say thank you and you come back to the center and it's all quiet and beautiful. So what the tracking project has been doing in a very simple way was just creating activities and thought processes to connect people directly with the natural world. And it's very simple to connect children because they're simple. You say something to them and they do it. They don't question you per se, they just jump in and do it. And once they're connected to that beautiful, nurturing matrix that we call nature, you don't have to tell them so much more, because they find their own place in it. They find through their own personal connection what they can do, what they should do, what feels good for them. So my job is just to, you know, and that's why the avatar was so cool. My job is just hooking ponytails up to the beast, you know. And once that sucker's hooked in, they're riding the thing. Yeah. And that movie was very beautiful to me. That's what I do. I hook up people. Now, there's a kind of tracker equation, or maybe, what would you call it, a syllogism or something. What we don't speak to, we don't understand. What we don't understand, we fear. What we fear, we destroy. Okay? What we don't speak to, we don't understand. It could be a person, it could be a thing, a concept, another country. So we don't understand it. What we don't understand, we fear. It becomes that thing. We don't know what it is. We don't have any connection to it. What we fear, we destroy. So working it backwards to stop the destructive cycle is as simple as speaking to the thing. Yeah, that's how you end the destructive cycle, is by beginning to speak to that thing. So when we get up in the morning, you know, perhaps the simplest thing is to greet the first bird that you see. The first bird that calls to you, the chickens. Or David, it's the chickens. The rooster.
Good morning,
chicken. You say, good morning, dude. The minor bird, the dove. And you just go outside and the world is beautiful. And you just greet it. And you say, good day. Yeah? That's what an Aborigine would say, good day. And here you would just say, aloha. And you just greet the world. And by speaking to it already, you've begun a dialogue. Because everything's alive. We all know that. Everything has sensibility, has intelligence. And it's our job to speak to that thing. And when we open that dialogue, it just ends the destruction, because we start to understand, we start to love and care for.